George has been traded to the Los Angeles Clippers and the Oklahoma City Thunder franchise, which looked like it was heading for another playoff push, now is forced to rebuild, and that means trading also their star point guard, Russell Westbrook. What is going on, y'all? Fast Sports Style back at it with another video talking, of course, some NBA. If you're new to the channel, welcome. Make sure to subscribe by clicking the button down below. I post daily NBA videos on the channel. You don't want to miss out. Ton of content. Go ahead and hit the bell icon to be notified every time I post a video. Also, go ahead and follow me on my social media links down below and on the screen for my Twitter and my Instagram. With that being said, here to talk about Russell Westbrook trade scenario, aka which team should trade for Russell Westbrook. So I'm going to be laying out which teams I believe should make a move for Russell Westbrook and ultimately the deals and how they could be pulled off. So as I always do, I'm going to keep it very simple with you guys and basically start listing out the teams that I believe should go after Russell Westbrook, have a legitimate shot at Russell Westbrook, and could make it work with Russell Westbrook. Okay, so let's list out the teams, okay, and go from there. So let's start at number one. So I've got four teams, as you guys can tell. And at number one, I've got the Detroit Pistons, okay? The Detroit Pistons, who, of course, have Blake Griffin and Andre Drummond, added Derrick Rose this year to the roster. They've got Markieff Morris. They're a playoff team. They were the 8th seed last year. And to me, they're still hovering around that 7th, 8th seed. They're a team that could use a guy like a Russell Westbrook to make a push because right now they're in no man's land. Again, the worst place to be in NBA is mediocrity, and that is you're not a title contender, but you're not one of the worst teams in the league to where you can get a draft pick. Now, we know the lottery system got reformed to where it doesn't reward the worst teams, but at the same time, the Pistons really, they're not a contender, and they need to shake things up. I believe Russell Westbrook can give them that second star alongside Blake Griffin to be able to make some sort of a push. I wouldn't make them contenders at that point, but they absolutely would catapult farther than they are right now. So it makes sense for the Detroit Pistons. Let's move on to number two with the Miami Heat. Another team with one star in Jimmy Butler, who they just acquired this year from Philadelphia in a sign-and-trade, and a bunch of like role players, misfits. They could definitely use Russell Westbrook. Now, again, two guys that are known to have a distaste for their teammates, two hotheads. As far as how they would get along in terms of the chemistry, it would be fun to watch. Boy, would I love to be in on those practices if this were to happen. But point being is, what do you have to lose here? Okay, it's similar to Detroit. Miami's not going anywhere. They could make the playoffs. They could miss the playoffs. Would you really be surprised either way? You wouldn't. So there you have it, number two, Miami. Let's move on to number three and go with the Orlando Magic, another team in basically mediocrity. So you guys kind of see the theme here, a lot of Eastern Conference teams and a lot of teams in mediocrity, with the Orlando Magic pretty much bringing everybody back that they had last year when they were a playoffs team. They were the 7th seed, I believe. You've got one sort of star. He made an all-star team last year, Nikola Vucevic. He's not a superstar by any means, but he's an all-star. And certainly, you could use the upgrade at the point guard position. They started DJ Augustine last year. We know Russell Westbrook is much better than him. But with that being said, again, nothing to lose here because the Orlando Magic team, I believe, has a clear ceiling with guys like Evan Fournier, Terrence Ross, Aaron Gordon. So to me, certainly, Orlando could take the gamble. And then finally, we've got the Minnesota Timberwolves, okay? The Timberwolves could also take a gamble here because, again, to me, they're a team that I thought were going to, you know, develop into one of the better teams, but that hadn't happened. Jimmy Butler got traded. You know, Derrick Rose left. Andrew Wiggins hasn't developed right. The only guy they have going for him is Karl Anthony Towns. But again, the theme here is one star. So you add Russell Westbrook to that team, and maybe you have a chance now to somewhat push yourself into the pack of teams in the Western Conference. Again, now we don't have a Golden State anymore. So again, it's a two-star lead. So maybe you do that. But from these four teams, I'm just going to say right now, with the Timberwolves, I'd like to eliminate them just based off the fact that in the Western Conference, I believe to me that a Western Conference team with Russell Westbrook, with how loaded the West is, wouldn't make too much sense. And the Orlando Magic, to me, I don't believe Russell Westbrook would want a trade to the Magic. there are reports that he would prefer the other team, so we're just going to take them out. So let's talk about these two teams who I believe are the legitimate contenders for Russell Westbrook. What would it take the Pistons? What would it take the Heat to get Russell Westbrook? And ultimately, who do I believe ends up getting Russell Westbrook? So now that we have limited the teams down to two, let's talk about realistic trade scenarios because, again, to be realistic, you have to factor in the salary cap. And the important number here to focus on is $38.5 million, okay? That is the salary of one Russell Westbrook this upcoming season. He signed to a five-year, $206 million contract. Yes, that's right, $200-plus million is what Russell Westbrook's contract is. And that is important. Why? Because, of course, we have to factor in the salary cap, which basically says that you have to bring in the same amount of money as you're sending out, okay? So to any team that wants to trade for him, you got to get close to this number to match and send back to the Oklahoma City Thunder. So I bring that up. Why? Because here's the thing. This contract is disgusting. And we know with teams, the value of Russell Westbrook around the league has decreased. Okay, folks, we've seen now another star not want to play with the Russell Westbrook. So what does that tell you? That means his value has decreased. He's been known as a bit of a stat pattern. So a lot of teams will say, okay, look, Russ is great, or we don't like Russ. Whatever the case may be, we're taking on this contract. No, we might want you to give us some assets because of how bad this contract is. So even if you think Russell Westbrook is still good, and he is, he's still a star in this league, maybe not a superstar, but certainly a star, this contract makes it even worse for him, okay? Makes him look worse, and he's a worse asset. He's a depreciating asset because he'll be making $40, $50 million by the time he's like 34, okay? This is the Chris Paul deal, if you will, okay? So to me, let's talk about the Detroit Pistons first. And the first player that we should focus on is Reggie Jackson, who's got a salary of about $18 million. You absolutely have to send Reggie Jackson because you have to clear point guard replacement here, right? And he makes a lot of money, so it makes sense. And he's an expiring deal. Keep in mind, I'm pretty sure the Thunder want expiring contracts. They're not going to want to take on big, big contracts. So Reggie Jackson absolutely makes sense here. And then to that, you're still obviously short about $20 million for Reggie Jackson. You're going to add another guy here in John Lewer, who makes about $9 million. And again, he's an expiring contract. That's the only reason that he's in here. As well as Langston Galloway, who makes about $7 million. So you add that up and you're going to get close to that number. And if the, you know, OKC Thunder want, you know, more assets in the deal, you can obviously throw in picks, or you can also throw in a young player like a Luke Kennard, who makes about $3 million on a rookie deal. And that will get you around to this number. Again, it doesn't have to be exact, but you just have to get close there, okay? This is about, what, 18 plus 9 plus 7, 16, 36, 39 million. We're about there, okay? So that is deal number one. Reggie Jackson, John Lewis, Langston Galloway, and Luke Kennard. Some draft picks, okay, maybe a first-round pick, et cetera, okay? Let's go to the Miami Heat, okay? And let's start with the other point guard on the Heat, Goran Dragic, who absolutely makes sense to send in this deal, and he makes about $19 million. He's an expiring contract, so absolutely you would include Goran Dragic. But then who else? Who else are you including in this deal? And I would throw in James Johnson, okay? JJ, I'm just going to say, and he makes about $15 million. Now, the problem with James Johnson is that he has a player option this upcoming season. So he is technically not expiring. And the other guy is Kelly Olynyk. So I'm just going to say Kelly O here. And he makes about, he makes about $11 million. Same thing with him. I believe he's got a player option as well. So it's tough here because these guys are not expiring, but you need their salaries to match here or to get to this level. So, but maybe to kind of entice them, you throw in a guy like a young player like a Justice Winslow, you know, who's making about $3 million. So you throw in a young player, you throw in some picks to entice him, and now you get to that magic number of about $38, $39 million. And that's kind of what a deal would look like. So this is what it would take for the Pistons. This is what it would take for Heat. This is somewhat of what a deal would look like for both teams. and realistically what the Thunder can expect in return. So to me, if I were the Oklahoma City Thunder, I think to me the best case scenario here is whoever gives me the most draft picks, but the more enticing sort of situation here is the expiring contracts, okay? Everybody on the Pistons is expiring. And if you throw in a young player and some draft picks, I'll take that over the Miami Heat, where they've got guys that are not expiring. So to me, I'll take the Pistons offer, but maybe, hey, you throw in, you know, Justice Winslow, it's a little bit more enticing. So again, either way you could go. I ultimately do think he ends up on the Detroit Pistons, but he's got mutual interest with the Miami Heat, so the Heat could obviously be a team as well. Again, to me, both are very good destinations. I don't have any issue with either. I think it's going to come down to draft picks. So let me know what you guys think. Where should the Oklahoma City trade Russell Westbrook? Should they trade him to the Pistons or Heat or another team? Comment down below if you agree or disagree. As always, thanks for watching.